Hi everyone, it's Kathy Zilski. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I've got a card featuring a trio of die cuts. The same die cut and a little bit of shimmer behind each one. This is a really simple technique to try and it packs a lot of punch. Let's take a look at some of the products I'm using today. The die that is featured on this card is called Peking Daisy. It's a very sweet die cut. I'm also going to be using a circle die from a nested circle die set that I have because I'm going to cut out some colorful shimmery panels. I'm also going to be using this banner die from Lawn Fawn. And for my card sentiment today, I'm using a sentiment from the Tiny Words Birthday. This is a really great all-purpose set with tons of birthday sentiments. Single line, double line, triple line, gosh, I think there's quadruple, maybe five. Lots of choices. I love that. For my ink colors today, I'm going to be using some Gina K inks. I've got Dusty Rose, Sweet Mango, and Sweet Corn. A great combination. I'm also going to be using my life-changing blender brushes to apply the color. For the shimmer, I've got some Nuvo Glimmer Paste in Moonstone and my palette knife to apply it. I'm also going to be using some embossing ink and a little gold embossing powder. This is Gilded from Brutus Monroe. Great embossing powder. And for my cardstock, I will be using Nina Solar White Classic Crest, only the 110 pound weight. I wanted something a little sturdier. So let's get started. I'm starting out by adding color in three separate circles to some heavyweight cardstock. And the goal is simple, have it look a little bit like it has a gradient. So get it a little darker at the base of where my circle will be and then let it blend out to be lighter around the edges. And the whole goal, just make sure that the circle I'm cutting is filled with color. So I'm gonna work through and do my orange, and I just decided to give them a little bit of space in between. It doesn't really matter because it's just all going to get die cut. The orange is down, and now the sweet corn. And again, a little darker and fading out. It does not have to be perfect because we are going to be covering this with glimmer paste. All right, ready to go. I've got my Spellbinders Platinum 6 machine, and I'm placing the die to encompass the yellow. I'm going to run that through, cut out my first circle, and then just repeat for the two others. I'm placing them back in the paper that I cut them out of just to hold them in place while I add my glimmer paste. And again, this is the Moonstone color. And I do think this is a good idea. It didn't quite work at first because I realized, oh yeah, you should probably try to seal it a little. So like press it so it's sticking. Does that make sense to the edge of the cut? And then just gently smooth it out. But I liked this for just holding it in place without any adhesive. And I'm going to repeat for the orange circle. And I'm just going over with, it's a very light amount and just even pressure because I don't want it to be goopy. I just want a nice smooth application of the glimmer paste. So pretty. Once I get this all on, I'll just lift these up just like I'm serving up a shimmery, glimmery pizza pie. And I'm going to let those dry for about 45 minutes. Next, I'm going to cut out my little windows. And I'm taking a little piece of tape, even though there are some dots on the back, I just want to visually represent where that stem is because I want these to be cut so that each of the flowers is pointing in a different direction. And I thought this was an easy way to do that. So I'm centering it, got my plate on there, and I will run it back and forth a few times. And you just want to be careful with these delicate dies to make sure that you don't bend those stems. Those stems are very dainty. And I've got a little foam pad here. I'll link below to this foam. I just got a piece of large craft foam and I cut it up, but it's really nice for poking out very delicate dies without worrying about bending them. Because here I can just poke straight down and get that little part out of the flower petal. It works really well and no delicate flower has been bent. I just repeated for the lower and upper flowers and just positioned them slightly at different angles. I think I did a good job. You can get real mathematical with this, but you know what? You can just eyeball it too. I'm going to stamp my sentiment. I'm hitting the cardstock with the embossing magic, and I'll take my embossing ink, get this all inked up, and press down with my Misti tool. Just run my finger over. I'm not pressing that hard. It's just to give it some even pressure. I'll add my embossing powder. And if you ever have extra powder, just take a dry brush and go over your piece before you heat set. Works great. There's always a few stragglers. And then get your heat tool nice and hot and bring it to the sentiment. It melts quickly. And now I have a really lovely, shiny, hope you have an awesome birthday. I'm going to use that banner die to make a quick, clean cut, and then I will trim that to size to fit on my card. I've added foam tape to the back, and I wanted to show you, I have a big roll. And anytime I have a little scrap, I just stick it to the side of the roll because I do not waste any of this. And also, if you ever have something really delicate, the craft pick is so great for stuff like that, like putting a tiny piece of foam tape on, because my fingers aren't that small, people. All right, I'm gonna score my card base. This will fold to be top folding. It's gonna be 4 1/4 wide by 5 1/2 tall, which is a standard US A2 size. Tape it closed as I am wont to do to keep it flat while I'm working. Now my shimmery pieces are dry and I'm going to use some dot runner. Just cover the back of each circle so that I can adhere it to the card base. I'll just line it up where I think it should go, press down, try not to move it, and then just double check to make sure it's in the right place. See, I just felt that doing the circles separately would minimize the warping on my card project. I could have done this right on the card base, but you know what? I like this better. It gives me more control and it minimizes that warp. I am popping that panel up right on the card base, and I'm going to add my little sentiment banner here, and I've popped that up also on some thin foam tape, and that's it. I was gonna add more things, and I said, no, nope, this is done. I really like the simplicity and all the shine. Now, I did an earlier card, and you can see a different placement on the banner. I used a different sentiment, and also, I love that I have matching envelopes for the inks that I'm using. Two different ideas, just a simple difference in the placement of the banner. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you give this technique a try, and I will see you back here with another card project soon.